What's up, guys? Your boys are back again. I'm Ryan, my man, George.
Yeah, man. Shout out to the free thinkers, man. Hopefully, y'all doing all right out there, man. Hopefully, you enjoyed your Thanksgiving.
Yeah, man. I know I did, but I'm still feeling the repercussions of all that food, man.
It was real.
You know what I'm saying?
It wasn't a game. So we got the game, Welcome Home.
This was a nice Black Friday gift, man. This came out today, right?
Fire. You know what I'm saying? I'm excited about this, man, because me and Ryan behind the scenes have heard. What's the joint with Anderson .Paak?
Stainless. Which is fire.
Which is hard. we've heard West Side.
With
the little Pac influence.
Yeah, man.
And the picture of me rolling sample on Stainless was dope too, with the Pac joint. So finally we have an excuse to actually do rap reactions again.
And it seems like this project is kind of taking us back to the roots of the West Coast. Mm-hmm. He got 25 tracks on this.
Yeah, we looking at it right now. That is crazy. I don't know what features. It doesn't really say the features right here on what we're looking at right now.
Yeah.
But I know that thing looks crazy. So it almost seems like it's double disc work.
Yeah.
I don't know if it's a double disc or not. It doesn't matter because it's on everyone's stream.
Yeah, exactly.
I don't know why I said double disc.
Anyway. No, but that just shows our age, man.
I'm 90s and, you know, All Eyes on Me and, you know, Life After Death. You know what I mean? That's the mindset I'm in with double disc.
Nipsey is on this with him, right? On Welcome Home
with
the game. So this might be kind of special, man.
Yeah, and that's why we were inclined to even do this one because of Nipsey. Because we could have did he's got 25 tracks. So we were more inclined to do this with Nipsey.
We could have did Gucci Flip Flops.
We could have did that. We don't know about that one. But and that might be hot though, because we haven't heard it. It might be hot. You know what I'm saying? But could be talking about the sweatshops and all that and how Gucci flip flops are made. It could be some substance there. I don't know.
I totally derailed the video on that.
Sorry. I'm just going off of it. But as it pertains to doing the one with Nipsey as well, you know, we've heard the rumblings, we've seen Game talk about Nipsey, we've seen kind of him more Nipsey, you know, after his death. And I know he kinda, a lot of people at least on social media gave him a little bit of flack for it, like, yeah, you ain't really know Nipsey like that, and yada, yada, yada. And then Game has been revealing, like, nah, dude, I put Nipsey on his first tour, him and, I believe, Kendrick. You know what I mean? So he's been doing interviews letting people know, like, nah, man.
And that's
me and him,
man,
were very close. So contrary to what the public may have been exposed to, he had a very close relationship with him. So that's kind of like, understanding that history is like, I wanted to see how he came with on this song with Nipsey. So,
and I like that he has the proof too, because if that's true, obviously you can go back and look at the records that, nah, me and Nipsey was actually super cool.
We were rocking.
You know what I'm saying? Because he was on tour with me.
Yeah.
You know? Which is dope, man.
Yeah.
And it's not like jumping on this Nipsey Hussle kind of bandwagon.
Exactly.
Which I think is like blasphemy, man. You shouldn't do that if you really didn't know about him, you know?
Yeah.
I mean, it is what it is.
I do think that's getting a little like, just because someone wants to show love to Nipsey and they appreciate what he's done, I don't think it's always about, oh, I'm just trying to get clicks by mentioning Nipsey's name. Because he legitimately was doing great progressive things. You know what I mean? So even if you didn't know about him until his death, you could still look and say, wow, I didn't know that much about Nipsey, but I gotta respect what he was trying to accomplish. So you can still show love, you know what I mean, and pay homage to him. So let's get into this one though, man.
Yeah, man.
The Game featuring Nipsey Hussle, Welcome Home. That sound like them drums that bum bum bum. It sounds like Black Rob. I think it's I Dare You. Go check that out. Black Rob, I Dare. I don't know if y'all know about that song, but the drums in this, and they probably even sampled the whole. It's probably the same sample, to be honest with you. Black Rob used, but bum bum bum. Listen to Black Rob, I Dare You. See if y'all can peep that. I could be wrong. That's what it sounded like to me.
Wake up every morning on the same shit. I smoke my wood to the roach like I ain't rich. Niggas I used to hang with is still gang with. Lamborghini outside, but nigga, that don't change shit.
Okay.
Same nigga that gave you classic after classic. Could still chop rock and zip it plastic after plastic. Why you think Dr. Dre don't take me on them yachts with him? Whispering to Snoop, this nigga probably got a Glock with him. Facts, smoke coming out the Rari hood. Nigga, I could fuck Nicki if Safari could. Motivation for all my niggas that's watching. All my niggas from Watts and South Central and Compton. I wish you could've been a fly on the wall in my dope spot, leaning with it tucked in my drawers. And I hope not, cause doing 25 to life is a roadblock. Welcome to my last album, Nip, time to close shop.
$20 million acting broke, nigga.
crazy.
All you niggas sleep, stay woke, nigga. All my niggas came up selling dope, nigga. Why the fuck you think they call us dope niggas? Broken home, broken dreams, no hope, nigga. Why the fuck you think we selling dope, niggas? This for all my dogs and my lokes, nigga. Gotta get our neck about these ropes, nigga.
Fly to the school, put you on the moon. Make America great.
That's hard.
This whole shit.
Yeah, he came
it's,
in.
It's tough.
Dirty, gritty.
First of all, before we get into it, Bongo, shout out to the producer, man. We'll make sure. Bongo, salute. I never even heard of Bongo, but dude, I'm sure he's done a lot of work in the industry. Name's not ringing
the
bell.
But even if he hasn't, this shit is hard.
This beat is crazy. He killed the sample. The way it dropped in was crazy. Go ahead, my bad.
What'd you think about the way Game came in on it, man? You think it's raw? Dirty?
Game is doing game, man.
Yeah, man.
Game, and salute to Game for just having a great ear for music, man.
Yeah,
and just understanding how to put a song together, man. I mean, it's hard to find a Game album that I don't at least like.
Yeah, it really is. That's true.
Game, you got to salute him, man. And that's kind of what I noticed. And we did the Stainless video. He kind of had the artwork of prior albums that he put in that video. And you really... Sometimes, man, you got to sit back and really look at someone's history and say, you know what? It's up to the artist sometimes, I think, as well, to remind motherfuckers. Mm-hmm. Like, dude, I've been out here. You know what I'm saying? Documentary, Doctor's Advocate, Jesus Peace, which I think is super, super underrated. And this is before people was saying Jesus Peace is underrated. When that first dropped, I said, dude, I don't know why people aren't talking about this album. He went crazy on that. So, yeah, man, he came in hard, though.
He embodies that rawness, that realness that I believe.
Yep.
Now, I'm like, you know what? Game is probably that nigga that'll give you the business. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, a lot of people talk about Game and some of the histories of him being on game shows and all this and, you know, the butterfly tattoo. Yeah. They say a lot, but he'll still beat the shit out.
Yeah.
Like, come on, let's keep it real. Not a lot of rap dudes that I think, you know, would stand with him.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? To give him his credit, at least.
Exactly, man. So, and that's just what we believe, man. It comes across in the music, is my point, man. And that's what I love about the way he started this, man. It seems like he's staying true to his roots. That's kind of what I'm hearing here. He's like, yeah, you know, I got Lamborghinis outside, but, you know what I'm saying, I still smoke my weed to the roach. I'm not rich, and I'm still in touch with the hood.
And
right?
It speaks to his hunger, too. You know what I mean? It speaks to him being in tune with the streets and understanding I'm not some dude that's lost his way. You know what I mean? And it speaks to his hunger. I still stay hungry. That's why he's able to have longevity, right?
Mm-hmm.
Keeping a certain hunger and a certain essence with creating great art.
Classic after classic, right? That's what he said there. I don't think he's literally out there selling drugs anymore, but I think
the mentality.
To your point, the mentality is still there. The hunger is still there, right? I'm still in tune with the hood as well.
He got Dr. Dre scared and shit on yachts.
He said, that's why you think he don't have me on his yachts. He's all because whispering to Snoop, oh, he probably got a Glock on
with him.
And he's all facts. I love that though, man. I love the realness, man. The chorus in this is hot too. I like Nipsey on the chorus, man. Always good to hear his voice, man. You gotta stay woke, you know. You got to know what's going on. You know, we got to get our necks up out of these ropes. Yeah, I'm still in the streets, but dude, you know, there's a certain level of elevation as well, I think.
Yeah, absolutely.
We all should have as well, man. So
it speaks to the mentality, man. I mean, Game is I don't think Game is actually in the streets anymore, but it speaks to him understanding, like, I'm not that far removed from the struggle and understanding and even remembering where I come from. You know what I mean? So I'm bringing you, I never really left home, but I'm also bringing you that feel, right?
Yep.
When you say welcome home, even just welcome back to getting that raw West Coast real shit.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I'm not some dude that's lost his way
from
that. So the beat is crazy. Dope chorus from Nipsey and Game. You know, Game's rapping as we expected. So let's keep it rocking.
This for all my dogs and my lokes, nigga. Gotta get our neck about these ropes, nigga.
Fly to the spoon, put you on the moon. Make America great again, you a fucking coon. And you niggas wonder why I'm unenthused. Cause hard bottoms trump running shoes. And the less you know, the longer you live. And the more you know, they tapping your crib. My niggas that say they got shot and actually did. Who never thought what happened to Pac, what happened to Big, what happened to L, what happened to Proof. And Jam J though, hip hop, I lean on you. R.I.P. to Fredo. Young niggas stay woke, old niggas stay woke. It's raining hollow tips, I'm dripping in this Gucci raincoat. Security won't pat me. Niggas won't at me, same nigga to say the West with a bald head and some khakis. Watching Kendrick show while Top Dog dab me. This my last album, motherfucker, I hope you happy.
$20 million acting broke, nigga. All you niggas sleep, stay woke, nigga. All my niggas came up selling dope, nigga. Why the fuck you think they call us dope niggas? Broke.
Tough. $20 million acting broke. I can have $20 million in the bank and I'm still acting like I ain't got nothing.
Acting the same.
And speaks to the grind and the hustle and making sure that you stay sharp And don't let complacency take over, man.
Yes, sir.
You know what I mean? So fire.
I'm loving this song, man, but this chorus is hard, course, man. So. Got to get our neck up out these ropes, you know? Mm-hmm. It's almost like we're born into a world that we've got to kind of compromise what we know is probably not necessarily right to mm-hmm. survive. But we're hanging ourselves at the same time.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? So it's like, I really love that chorus. And that's a lot being said in a short period of time.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know what I'm saying?
I love that. I think that's great. But let's keep it going. Yeah, let's keep it going. We'll finish it up, guys.
All you niggas sleep, stay woke, nigga. All my niggas came up selling dope, nigga. Why the fuck you think they call us dope niggas? Broken home, broken dreams, no hope, nigga. Why the fuck you think we selling dope, niggas? This for all my dogs and my lokes, nigga. Gotta get our neck about these ropes, nigga. This shit's over. Save your last shit, I don't believe you, Chuck. I remember LAX.
Like me and Ryan was just saying, this breakdown
right here. Yeah, it's a nice little breakdown right here, man.
Took the drums out and let it rock.
Mm-hmm.
Fire.
And it's beautiful because it's almost, well, because Nipsey's not here anymore. And you hear that, you're like, oh, man, it almost brings a smile to your face, man. I love this right here.
It's good to hear him talk his talk, for sure.
Say this your last shit, I don't believe you, Chuck. I remember LAX, nigga. Bring that beat back for me though. I gotta say something.
Good bass in that. Good work.
Yeah. Chuck, what up? I was like, fuck rap music, I'm gonna rob me a bank. Starving artist ain't my style, that shit'll drive me insane. Gave my mind to these millions and my heart to the gang. Probably die up in these streets, but I survived through my name.
That's great.
Every nigga around me killers and I doubted a change. If the police get behind us, we go out with a bang.
That's crazy how prophetic that
I
was.
I know, man.
That's crazy. God, probably die up in these streets, but I survived through my name.
That's exactly what happened, right?
That's
exactly
prophetic.
What happened, man. You know? Starving artists ain't my style. That shit'll drive me insane, mm-hmm. you know? And I can imagine being from the hood and trying to find a way out through music, right? Mm-hmm. I can understand it. It's easy for me to go get this bag real quick. Mm-hmm. Let me just go get this bag. Fuck rap music. You know what I'm saying? Let me just get this bag. So, and the line that you just touched on, man, I survived through my name, man. I mean, dude, it's just, that's so surreal to me, man. It's crazy. Because that's exactly what's happening. That's exactly what's happening.
You know, I always look at, when I hear people talk about selling drugs and just violence and this and that, I always look at that perspective as sort of a microcosm of what I feel most, a microcosm of like an apocalyptic scenario. And I think that most people, whatever your morals are, put under different circumstances, those morals would change, right?
Yep.
It's like if you didn't have any food, and this dude over here in an apocalyptic scenario had food and they weren't trying to share their food with you.
Yes.
A lot of people under those circumstances would then sort of shift their morals because you're trying to get food for your family to feed your family in that scenario, right? So I just think if you're looking at these guys, I look at it like it's not an apocalypse. It's not an apocalypse, but I look at them being in the jungle and the rules are just different when you're struggling and you're hungry and
your back's against the wall.
And that's the perspective. That's why I don't get too caught up in worrying about subject matter. I want to hear these stories. And hopefully from hearing these stories, we can learn the why behind it. Once we know the why, let's work to changing that. So all these perspectives, when I talk about substance, guys, I've talked about that a lot. This is substance filled. It's not about just talking about conscious shit that's saving the world.
Yeah.
It's just talking about real perspectives and having meaning and purpose.
And be able to share that story in a creative way.
Creative, well-written. That's true to you. Yep, that's true to you. You know what I'm saying? So that's just real.
I feel you.
You know? So let's keep it going. Let's finish it up.
Every nigga around me killers and I doubted a change. If the police get behind us, we go out with a bang. Early 2000s, murder rate was a shame. We was saying bullets got no names. Nigga, we're as charismatic on these corners like Tupac on stage. But fuck a dream if it's not gonna pay. Feel me? White Sox hat with my Glock on waist. Couldn't tell me I was not O'Shea. Posted at the quickest split. Don't get caught on tape, cause they put them cameras up since they shot Quinshay.
Chuck.
I remember your white range. Slauson Ave, ran up on you, gave you my mixtape. Now,
$20 million acting broke, nigga. All you niggas sleep, stay woke, nigga. All
my niggas came up selling dope, nigga. Why the fuck you think they call us dope, nigga? Broken home, broken dreams, no hope, nigga. Why the fuck you think we selling dope, nigga? This for all my dogs and my lopes, nigga. Gotta get our neck about these ropes, nigga.
They killed that.
Yeah, that's smart.
Yeah, that was hard. Mm-hmm. That was real hard. I think they killed that. Yeah, I love both games and Nipsey's contributions. And I did want to touch on a line here when Nipsey said, Sloss Nav ran up on you. He was talking about Game when he said, Chuck, I remember you and your white range. Sloss Nav ran up on you, gave you my mixtape. And that's what Game was talking about when he was doing his press run for his album. When people were kind of coming at him about how he was mourning for Nipsey, basically saying that he was essentially maybe clout chasing or whatever the case may be, or giving that impression. He was saying that, you know, when he was touring, he put Nipsey and Kendrick on as the opening acts as he was touring. I think they toured around the world, he said. And he was saying this specific thing that Nipsey said, like, yo, I remember I saw Nipsey on Slauson. I didn't know who he was. He gave me his mixtape.
Yeah.
And then, you know, I gave him a shot or whatever the case may be. And then here we are. So all this stuff that I was doing online of me mourning him, like, I know this man. You know, we really are close. So to hear Nipsey say that, I think is saying that. It speaks volumes. It kind of goes against the people who are just looking at Game like he was just trying to just take advantage of Nipsey's name or whatever the case may be just for clout. He's like, nah, man, that was really his friend. So I thought that was important. And I just think that Nipsey's whole verse was just very prophetic and sort of eerie in a sense. You know what I mean? Because, again, this is a prediction of what actually
happened.
You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Especially when he's talking, when he had that line here posted at the Quicken split, don't get caught on tape.
Yeah, man.
That's interesting because of
how he
was caught on tape.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? Just, it was from a gas station, I believe, or at least one of the camera angles was from that. Not saying that that's necessarily relevant to what he was saying in that line, but it makes you think. It takes you back to that. Dope song, Welcome Home. Man. Game, to me, is just bringing you back to the essence, letting you know that ain't shit changed. I'm still this dude that's still hungry. I'm also at the same time, I know I'm an OG in the game, and I have wisdom. I've accumulated wisdom, right, throughout my time, and he's sharing that wisdom. You know what I mean? And I think that's how you make an impactful record. You know what I mean? I thought he infused Nipsey on this very well. I love how they let Nipsey just talk his talk without the drums in it. They wanted you to hear what Nipsey was saying.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? And that's how you make a classic, man. That's how you make classic records. That's a very memorable, impactful record.
Big time.
That I think that he did well.
Yeah, man. One line I wanted to touch on here, man, before we ended it, man. He said early 2000s, Murder, Inc., it was a shame. You know what I'm saying? He was all, we was just, bullets had no name. He was like, we were just shooting that bullets had no name, man. And for a while there, man, back in the day, it was really, really bad, man. You know, and Murder, Inc. was an actual record label, you know what I'm saying, with Ja Rule and them. So I thought that was a cool...
Feds ran down on them, too.
Yeah, you know, so...
the history of that.
So I thought that was real surreal, the way he brought that, painted that picture, man, because it, in a literal sense...
It was murder. It was
it
murder.
It really was. You know what I'm saying?
It was wild.
You know...
It was in the streets. It was in the field.
Exactly,
also,
man.
Also, Murder, Inc. in the early 2000s had their run-ins... as well, you know,
right, man. That's one thing I miss about old hip hop albums in general, man. And Kendrick does that, Cole does that. There's only a few people that really do that now, that really paint a picture and tell you a story.
It's just perspective, man.
Yeah, of what's going on and what's in your mind and all that kind of stuff. And you're putting it in it, and that's kind of what makes art to me, you know. And you really don't see that a lot in the new school. It's let me just make a banger after banger after banger. Let me just hit, if the beat's hot, it doesn't matter really what I'm talking about, you know? So, dude, I love this song, man. This was really cool. It was
everything
really
about it.
Crazy.
Love the title of the album too, Born a Rap. And I think that that's just what Game is doing, man. He's letting you know that this is real rap to me. That's what it sounds like.
Yeah, man.
Born to Rap is a very hip hop thing to say, like, no, I'm here to rap. I mean, I'm gonna give you that which y'all been missing, man, in the mainstream at least. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to Game, man. I'm excited about the album. Rest in peace, of course, to Nipsey Hussle. That's the end of the video. If you guys enjoyed that, please hit the like button. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. I'm George. That's Ryan. Las Vegas.
We out.
We out.